Hello, everyone. We're at Heretic Games in San Bruno, California. Nice little game store here. This is Tony. We're here for a Drop Fleet Commander battle report. I'll remind everyone that I'm not actually very good at Drop Fleet Commander. So again, like, I'll probably make plenty of mistakes tactically. Feel free to point those out in the comments. I don't mind. I'm definitely trying to learn and get better at this game. The mission we're doing is called Grid Control. The way this works, we have a space station in the middle. It has four burn-through lasers on it, so it has a lot of weaponry if you can take control of it. We have two very small clusters over here in the sides. Each one also is full of weaponry, and then we have these home clusters with three sectors in them. These count as double points. As a reminder, points are scored at the end of turns four and six. Are we controlling the airspace over the clusters this time? Yeah, including the space station or just not including the space station? So, and how about the home clusters?
Yeah.
Okay, so all four of the clusters here also contribute points if you are winning the battle in low orbit over them at the ends of turn four and six. All right, we'll be back in a second with the fleets.
All right, so starting off with UCM, we have a New York class heavy carrier. That'll be my flag battle group. Followed by a group of two strike carriers and three Santiago corvettes to give myself some atmosphere coverage. Another troop unit, a detachment of two strike carriers and a San Francisco class troop ship. Here's two Saratoga class light cruisers and a Lima supporting them, so that sensor coverage will be great. More big guns. So here is a Seattle class carrier and a, That's the Avalon, the battle cruiser with the super heavy laser. And finally, a destroyer squadron of four, whatever the hell, Taipeis. That's right, the close action ships. So we'll see what these do.
All right, going through the PHR fleet. First off, we have a battle group with two Bellerophons. Next battle group, one Bellerophon and one Orpheus troopship. Over here we have a battle group with a Orpheus troopship and I believe an Orion light cruiser. Is that right?
The Theseus.
The Theseus for light cruiser. We have a battle group with two Medea strike frigates and three corvettes, and another battle group exactly the same, two strike frigates, three corvettes.
So first thing is the battleship, the heavy carrier, comes in under full thrust to try to get up the board a little bit closer.
And drops to low orbit.
It also dropped to low orbit, that is absolutely.
Alright, so my Bellerophon came on with a minimum movement so it can do its thing where it just drifts and shoots stuff from long range. The Orpheus took a max thrust and got a minor spike, which I will put on it now, and also descended to low orbit.
So, coming on board is the San Francisco class troop ship, which is on standard thrust and is descending to low orbit in order to drop on the city. And two New Orleans class strike carriers going full thrust to attempt to get closer to the action of both the gun sector and the station.
Alright, so activated this battle group with the strike carriers. They moved on into max thrust, got minor spikes, and this little group of corvettes just took a standard action over here and descended to low orbit. Alright, turn one roundup phase. Not too much going on here. Really the only thing of note is that Tony's, San Francisco?
San Francisco.
Dropped a whole bunch of troops down into that industrial sector. Alright, activated my Medeas and Echoes. The Medeas went down into atmosphere, lost their spikes, standard orders. And the Echoes took standard orders, again went forward almost the full 12 inches, dropped into atmosphere, and they're just chilling out over by that spot.
New York class battleship moved up, adjusted its course and lost its spike by being on standard orders, and fired its medium mass drivers at the enemy troop ship. Landed one hit through the armor for just a single point of damage, so first shot of the game.
Alright, activated my Orpheus and the Bellerophon. Orpheus went first, flew up here so it can drop off its troops later, fired its laser at the front, rolled pretty well, did a damage, and put a minor spike on it, and that minor spike put it in range of the Bellerophon. Bellerophon dropped an orbital layer, took a standard action, fired its laser, also rolled quite well, did 4 damage to the battleship, there, the big carrier over there.
A new group of strike carriers arrived on the board, one of them going to each debris field and hiding behind it under full burn, as well as a group of corvettes moving up the side to go and intercept the enemy corvettes for control of that gun sector.
All right, activated more small ships. Another set of strike frigates or strike carriers came up here, and they're actually in low orbit. Let me fix that. And the corvettes came up right beside them, so I got 6 corvettes over here.
So, coming on was a Lima-class recon ship.
Oh, yeah, over there.
It fired its sensor array and went active scan, picked out the troop ship, which gave enough targeting resolution for the two Saratoga-class light cruisers to converge and fire both their beams. I rolled pretty bad, so it's only taken 4 damage from the attack.
Or 3, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so I rolled on an Orpheus troop ship, went nice and slow, fired my laser at his battleship, and did a little bit of damage. Unfortunately, because of the distance here, you can't actually quite get on, go to low orbit, and get in drop range in one turn, because they only thrust 7, so I won't be able to drop until next turn, that's okay. Right on the Theseus, also just kind of angled on, and he's heavily spiked right now and has a huge signature, so I'm just taking pot shots from the far edge. Shot it, and did 2 more damage. So the battleship's now down to 10 points, it's one more and it'll be have to roll on the damage table.
So, moving in, one of the strike carriers decides to go for the space station, moves up, attempts to engage the enemy troop ship, doesn't do any damage to it, while its friendly troop ship moves up to prepare for next turn.
This one here?
Yep. That's the one. Okay. Over here, another one of the strike carriers decided to enter the jaws of hell as 6 corvettes are bearing down on it, to at least get somebody on the ground of the orbital gun before enemies attack, so I'll get 1 turn use of it.
Turn 2 roundup phase. So, bomber launches. His New York carrier just launched all the bombers right at my Orpheus troop ship. Fighter launches. My Bellerophon launched 4 wings of fighters to try to defend it. We rolled it all out. It took a bunch of damage.
8
damage. Or, well, 5 damage initially, but that required a critical damage roll, which was a weapons offline. And that's awful because I was about to deploy all my troops in there, but the weapons offline means that now it can't launch anything in the next phase. So he's going to uncontested have his strike carrier take control of all the guns on the space station, and I can't launch anything. So that's terrible. That was really, really lucky for Tony. Over here, I dropped tanks down into this cluster, and he dropped a tank down onto that massive gun there.
So I got the initiative on this one. I had the Lima target the enemy Bellerophon before it activated, and the pair of Saratoga-class light cruisers closed in and fired their burn-through lasers. I rolled like complete trash and did 2 damage from the pair of heavy burn-through lasers on the target.
Yeah, really dodged a bullet there. Alright, activated my Orpheus and my Bellerophon. My Orpheus had 1 damage left and a torpedo bearing in. There was no way it was going to survive the turn, so I rammed his New Orleans. And I rolled my 3 up, and I got to roll 13 dice, because that's my original hole amount, and I smashed into the New Orleans and completely destroyed it. So they're both gone. Bellerophon fired its burn-through laser at the Beijing, moved up minimum, went down to a minor spike, rolled really well, did 5 damage to it. It's now below, or 6 damage to it. Yeah, it's now below half. It has orbital decay, and it has a hole breach. So it's down to 4 dice, and hopefully it'll smash into the atmosphere. All right, activated my 2 Bellerophons. They were off the board. They just flew on. The only thing they could shoot was the battleship, so they just fired their burn-throughs at the New York and finished it off. It exploded, didn't hurt anything.
Pretty quick activation for me. 4 Taipei-class missile frigates came on, going full burn, staying at high orbit, and using the debris field as cover in really close formation. So, coming on now is the Avalon-class battlecruiser going silent running and staying at high orbit. And escorting it over there is the Seattle-class light carrier coming on at standard orders and high orbit.
All right, activated my Medeas and Echoes. The Echoes flew up, unloaded everything they had, got really, really lucky with the rail cannons, rolled 3 hits in atmosphere, blew up his strike frigate, and then my strike frigates moved up, and they'll drop at the end of the turn, assuming they're alive. So yeah, activated my Orpheus. It really couldn't do much useful, so it just kind of flew forward to drop the guys and shot the space station, because he's controlling it, did 1 damage. And then the Theseus kind of angled this way, and I can't really shoot anything. So, very boring activation.
So, moved up the troop ship. The San Francisco is now basically ready to do final approach on the space station and put enough troops on it that I think I'll be able to hold it.
And you shot me.
And I fired ineffectively.
At the Bellerophon, did no damage. Just cancel. All right, activated these frigates over here. They just did the deployment wiggle, and they're going to drop some guys. Then these corvettes kind of angled slightly, flew in atmosphere, which is very slow. Took a couple 6-up pot shots against the New Orleans, and did nothing.
So, strike carriers did a bit of a bold move. They both full thrusted. One went behind this debris field, and the other did a dash to enter atmosphere right in front of the enemy troop formation. It's not going to launch this turn, but next turn it's going to do something.
And I don't have a lot of great ways to shoot it.
And over here, knowing that they're probably going to die and trying to pin down stuff and take stuff down before they come in, the Santiago squadron, outnumbered, goes in and dives after one of the Medea class strike carriers, does 2 damage to it, not enough to put it down though.
All right, and end of turn 3, specifically the ground lasers. So your space station fired all 4 of its ridiculously powerful lasers and blew up my Bellerophon, and it radiation fielded and did 2 damage to the other cruisers that were near it. I fired my super deadly ground laser and blew up your New Orleans cruiser, had a spike on it, and that was it.
That was it?
Yep.
Good turn.
All right, and the end of roundup phase for turn 3, I dropped a whole bunch of troops down there. Some tanks down there, and some tanks down there, and he loaded up the space station with a whole bunch of guys. And I launched 8 bombers at his San Francisco there, and he put 3 fighter wings in defense from the Seattle, and that'll all resolve next turn. All right, I activated my group of little guys. The corvettes had a pretty bad turn of rolling. They only damaged a single one of his corvettes for 1 damage. The frigates climbed, and well, one of them climbed. This one here is now in low orbit. This one stays in atmosphere because I want to drop 1 more guy on the surface. But I want to have somebody in low orbit in order to score at the end of turn 4.
So, cinematic moment right here with 8 squadrons of PHR bombers, the deadliest bombers in the galaxy, bearing down on this troop ship, this barely armed troop ship, with his 3 squadrons of fighter support. He did a course change maneuver into a fine debris field to scrape off enemy planes. So of the 8 squadrons, 6 were scraped off by, 5 were scraped off by contact with the debris field, and then 2 more were shaken off by evasive maneuvers, leaving 1 squadron of bombers to come after it, where 1 squadron of UCM fighters and point defense guns managed to hold them off for no damage. The ship took minor damage, 1 point from hitting a piece of debris.
Yeah, and killed 2 of its own fighters in the process, but, you know, details.
Worth it.
So I'm in an awkward spot here with these ships because he's just out of range with those 2 light cruisers still. And I don't really have a great way to active scan them. So what I ended up doing was just kind of maneuvering here and shooting at him in the debris field, which is a pretty hard shot. I ended up doing 2 damage, so not that much.
So Corvette Squadron decided to leave atmosphere to chase after the strike carrier attempting to gain orbital dominance. They managed to take him down, and his explosion just barely stopped from reaching the lead Santiago. And meanwhile, on the other sector with the strike carrier, the bravest strike carrier in the world has continued in atmosphere to get within drop range of the enemy's home platform.
All right, the Medeas just climbed up into low orbit so that they can score at the end of turn 4. And my Echoes decided to course change and move behind this debris field here. They've got minor spikes, but they're going to go try to... they're going to have to go through the debris field or something. But they're going to go try to hurt this New Orleans over here.
All right, so the 2 Saratogas currently still doing pretty good. They actually rolled pretty well today. They moved as slow as they possibly could and engaged the enemy troop ship, knocking it down to 3 points.
Oh, with the scan, too.
With the scan.
The Echo has just been sitting back there scanning.
The Lima
scanning
is still back there designating targets, making sure that it has a clean lock, and helping me stay at arm's length. So that ship is currently, with a hull breach, losing altitude from low orbit and with 3 hull points left.
All right, activated my Bellerophons. I didn't have a lot of great choices here. It was really just... I can take a terrible shot at a San Francisco in the debris field, or I can shoot the space station, because these, whatever those are called...
The Saratogas.
Saratogas are just too far away. So patriotic, what a name. So they moved up just minimum and shot the space station, but I only managed to do 2 damage to it because I rolled really badly, so not great.
So, moving up, Seattle-class light carrier had no targets. It's within range of various things to actually launch fighters, though, so I decided not to shoot it. Instead, it went active scan, gained a major spike, and identified the Theseus, which is just within range for the Avalon-class battlecruiser to move in, fire its super heavy laser, and deal all but 1 damage to the ship, which then failed due to its critical damage roll, exploded, and failed to harm its colleague, the troop ship, which is still falling, but great roll for me. So last action of this turn by our ships, my squadron of Taipeis moved in under standard orders, descended to low orbit, and fired light mass drivers at the troop ship, which they intended for 1 more point.
All right, so this is the roundup phase of turn 4 for the ground combat and the shooting. So I couldn't really shoot anything from there. Nothing's going on there. I shot the brown laser at the corvette and did 1 damage. We fought over the green laser and we both died. And then you took the space station and took 1 of its lasers and killed a corvette. And the other 3 lasers fired at my troop ship that was there and horribly overkilled it, and it is vaporized.
There's a lot of dead cyborgs.
Yeah, pretty much. And I think that's it.
Yep.
All right, launch assets and scoring. I launched all my bombers at the space station. He launched all his fighters at the space station. That'll resolve a whole turn from now. And then scoring, we scored it all up. So I got the bottom, the ground. He has the air for that. I have the ground. He can test the ground, and then I have the air for this one. I have ground and air for this one. He has the space station, and he has ground and air for that. Add all that up, and Tony's winning 15 to 13 after turn four.
All right, so first activation of this turn, the Corvette squadron moved in low orbit after the enemy Corvettes to try to stop them from intercepting the strike carrier. Rolled nine dice, failed to kill one of the Echoes.
Yeah, made very some bad good armor saves.
Yes.
And your
strike carrier just moved forward. It's directly over the city, and hopefully it can survive long enough to drop more troops on the enemy position.
All right, activate my Bellerophons. I'm really just trying to take the space station out at this point, because I think that's my best hope for the mission. However, I rolled badly again, only did like one damage to it. Yeah.
Yep, that's one damage. Well, those bombers are going to do some more damage, so we'll see.
Eventually. All right, activated my one group of Echoes. They blew up a Santiago, and my strike carriers from this cluster went over there with a full move and dropped down to atmosphere.
So, moving up is a battlecruiser advanced, fired its super laser at the Bellerophon, and managed to knock off 7 points of damage, plus set it on fire. So, we'll see if that thing survives this round. The carrier, meanwhile, did a burn retros maneuver, shot down one of the escaping Echoes over there to try to defend my strike carrier, and is keeping its place right there at where it's at with a heavy spike.
All right, activated my Echoes. My remaining Echo moved over here, dropped into atmosphere, shot the strike carrier, did one damage, and the Medea just stood still, basically. And the problem here is that it's so dangerous to go to either of these spots, because I'd have to basically move fast this turn and stay in low orbit in range of all these missile frigates that I just get murdered, so I don't think that's a smart idea. So he's just going to stay there.
So the Saratogas continue to advance. They moved a lot faster this turn, trying to close the distance since we're already definitely at knife fighting range. And they managed to inflict one whole damage on the Bellerophon by flubbing a bunch of rolls. But
yeah,
you know what? At this point,
real
that's
lucky.
Fine. All right, so with PHR done with their ships, the Taipei squadron barreled in, rolled a 27 missile salvo on the Bellerophon, and managed to knock it down to 8 hit points.
Yep.
The other Bellerophon then just watched as the troop ship drove up, preparing to drop at low altitude, and did nothing. So we're going to see where the surface space fire happens on this turn, because it's going to be nasty.
Turn 5 roundup phase for ground combat and ground shooting. I shot my first burn through laser here at the battlecruiser, did a bit of damage, and that gave him a spike because of the flash ability, which put him in range of all of the other lasers, so I fired everything at it. And it
knocked off almost half his hit points.
Almost half, yeah, but not quite anymore
not
than
quite.
That. And then the space station fired at my two Bellerophons and actually rolled pretty badly, all things considering. They're both at 4. But that one has cracked armor, and that one is still on fire, so I've still got problems. And then in ground combat, the only combat was here. I split some of my troops and put 2 troops on the tank. They fought, and I lost one troop, and he lost the tank. That's a great trade for me, actually. Turn 5, launch assets. So we went ahead, and we hadn't resolved the space station shots yet, so I had 8 bombers on there. He had 3 fighters. The space station had a base point defense of 12, so we had an epic space battle, and I did 7 damage out of 12, so the space station was down to 5. Then we went to the launch phase, because those were resolving from last turn. And I had 2 Bellerophons left still, so they launched another wing of 8 bombers, but because they were within 12 inches, they immediately resolved. So we had another epic space battle. He lent fighters over from the Seattle, but 2 of them got killed in the debris field on the way over, so we only had 1 fighter this time. And we rolled all that out again, and this time I did like another 7 damage or so, and the space station blew up, did a radiation burst, so these guys are all damaged now. He got crippling damage on the battlecruiser, so it's on fire. So yeah, that was a lot of damage over there. Then, in terms of deployment, I dropped an extra tank down there, and he dropped a whole bunch of tanks and infantry here because he finally got all these dropships to my home objective. So, unfortunately, I have a disadvantage in that fight now. We'll probably end up losing that on the last turn, but I did blow up the space station.
All right, so eventful turn. The fleet carrier adjusted its maneuver to regain orbital control over its home sector and fired long-range mass drivers, which did a few more damage to one of the armor-cracked Bellerophon, but didn't kill it.
So the Atlantis went in, went weapons free, fired the main cannon at the enemy Bellerophon directly in front of it, and did all but one damage to it, so it's still up. Its secondary turrets took down the other Bellerophon, which rolled a distortion bubble on its drives.
But I only rolled a one in radius.
Explosion size was too small. Nothing was damaged.
If I had rolled like a five or a six on the distortion bubble, I could have wiped out so many ships. But
especially if you cause a chain reaction with the frigate squadron.
Yeah, that would have been amazing. But unfortunately, it didn't happen.
Alas, not. All right, so what happened was that with a single Bellerophon, with one hit point remaining, and a group of four missile frigates, two light cruisers, and a battle cruiser bearing down on
it. Oh, and a troop ship,
and a troop ship. It rams the troop ship, succeeds, cripples the troop ship, causes an energy surge, which caused the troop ship to be destroyed. Troop ship rolls on the catastrophic damage table, distortion bubble, its reactor goes up, blast size, 5 inches. So it catches half the fleet in it. So the blast immediately destroys the battle cruiser, cripples both light cruisers, takes out two missile frigates, who then chain react, causing shredded explosions, which destroy the other two missile frigates. And both light cruisers barely hang on by the skin of their teeth.
By rolling a bright light, and then nothing happens.
By rolling a bunch of energy surges as their critical damage, leaving them with one hit point and four hit points. So that's six less UCM ships on the table.
Yeah, this all got blown up by my single ram. Incredible.
Incredible.
All right, activated my corvettes. They kind of turned hard. They all use spikes again. All shot their close action shots at the corvette that was undamaged. It blew up, and then they shot all their guns at the Saratoga that was down at one hit point and spiked, and that blew the Saratoga up. No crazy catastrophic results.
Thank God it
results.
Did not chain react.
Yeah. and then these guys just went down into atmosphere to prepare to drop at the end of the turn and tried to bombard a bit, but didn't do any damage.
Just for shits and giggles at this point, just for the hell of it, the last surviving light cruiser moves up, tries to fire at the corvette in atmosphere, and just whiffs completely. But he's well within range to dominate the airspace.
All right, my Medea just went up into orbit and fired. What does it fire? Oh yeah, it's close action shot at the corvette, but it's a terrible shot, so it didn't do anything. This guy rotated, shot the close action at the strike carrier, didn't do anything, and the gun at the guy in orbit and hit on a six, but it didn't do anything.
So this is the last move for our ships, and we'll have to do everything else afterwards, but my strike carrier, the hero that injected himself into the enemy territory and captured parts of the enemy base, fired up with his cannon, rolled a six, managed to shoot down that corvette that could have been coming for him. And my other corvette, being a hero, having no more mission there, attempted to take out one of the enemy corvettes remaining and failed miserably. So now we're going to have to go and wrap up and see what ground combat looks like.
All right, end of the game. So the end of the roundup phase, really we just had a little bit of ground fighting here. He got the better of it, killed my infantry in that part and in that part. So he actually won two of the sectors, got the whole cluster. And I successfully dropped a tank over there, but that didn't actually really do me any good because you actually have to hold the sector in order to get the whole cluster. So I don't get any points for that. That's about it. So for scoring, he wins air and ground over here and over there. Because that cruiser's still in range. I win ground here, no one wins air, and I win air and ground over there. We tallied up the points. You ended up with 31. I ended up with
18.
So still a pretty big win. Less disastrous than it was going to be because I managed to blow up so much of his fleet towards the end, but he still won the ground war. So let's talk through it. Clearly the big move at the beginning of the game was when my troop ship got disabled and couldn't drop troops on the space station. That was a critical moment of the game, and I don't think at that point I had quite realized just how deadly that space station is once you have control of it. Because if I had had troops on there, we would have been fighting for several turns. No one would have had control of the lasers. But having four heavy burn through lasers in the center of the board just killing anything on the board is really, really powerful. And Tony had that for three turns, basically.
Three turns. It was knocking out a cruiser turn when it was rolling okay. And because Cameron had massive corvette superiority, I knew my strike carriers would not survive in atmosphere, so I beelined it straight for that station.
Yeah, pretty much. And I think I got really unlucky with the cruise. Like, I think my strategy in most cases would have been sound to send a troop ship in there to drop on turn two. Usually it's not going to die. Mm-hmm. I just got a little unlucky there. And, if I want to play it safe in the future, you just send a little more to make sure you land on that station.
And this is exactly why it was totally worth it to trade my 260-point heavy fleet battleship carrier for one of those 130 odd point troop ships because it was the objective.
Yeah.
I had to do it.
Yeah, that basically, I mean, by getting the space station, that effectively gave him the equivalent of another battleship. That's basically what that station was. Yeah, with the four blazers, it doesn't take a crippled damage when it's half. It has 3-up armor save, 16 health. It's a really, really tough thing to blow up. So you basically just traded one battleship for another by taking that out. So it was a good, you know, sacrifice the queen sort of moment.
And this was another scenario where, because we're both very heavy in burn-through lasers and flight groups, we actually approached very slowly and had standoff distance for most of the time, which gave the UCM the advantage in using Lima to constantly pick out one target to focus down every turn with burn-through lasers.
While that Lima is probably the MVP of the whole match right there.
Exactly, without firing
don't
shot.
Don't discount the importance of active scan, especially if you're playing with a lot of lasers in fleet. Or spill lasers, specifically.
And with the PHR forces, although the Bellerophons could have active scanned as they came in, that would have revealed them as much as they revealed the enemy. And that means I was able to maintain range superiority with the Avalon and especially the Saratogas for the entire game to put on pretty steady damage.
Yeah, and he was able to just sort of like kind of slowly advance and start picking up all my guys between the Saratogas, the Battlecruiser, which is called
the Avalon,
yeah. So, I mean, my lesson here, I think the main... This is a relatively strong list, I think. I just need to add a little bit more frigate support for active scan purposes. Either the carriers or the laser ones would be good candidates for that. Just to, you know, if I'm taking so many Bellerophons, I need to have something that is going to reveal the targets and spike them at longer range. So that was a lesson for me. And then also commit a little bit harder to that center objective because it's extremely important. You cannot have it fall into enemy hands, especially early in the game, because it does so much damage in this variant of the scenario. Any other advice? I think just in terms of like the minutiae, you're just a lot better at this than I am. Like little things, like, you know, making sure your guys are pointed the right direction and picking the right order, like minor positioning stuff. I noticed a lot of things where my guys were like pointing the wrong direction, or you like ran behind them and then I couldn't shoot you. There's a lot of little stuff like that.
I'd say one thing I found really nice was I was always under the threat at long range of being lasered or at close range of being hit by those PHR bombers, which you never want to be hit by. But I think the cinematic moment of the game was when we had a wave of 8 PHR bombers about to throw 16 2-up dice at my troop ship. And so I had to full burn into the debris field to scrape off most of them. That was huge because that was actually my game winner, because that allowed my troops to survive long enough to deposit troops on the main objective.
Yeah, the bomber, if you hadn't managed to duck into the debris field and kill the bombers, you could not have dumped this wave of troops onto here and I would have won the sector. And I don't think they would have fully swung it, but between that and the space station, that was the game.
I would not have had enough time to kill your remaining troops or to conquer enough sectors, I'd say, at that point.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah. Anyway, that was a really, really fun game. A lot of like really cool moments, so appreciate it. And I know I promised last video that I would try to make one video a month. It's been a little over 2 months since my last video, but I'll keep working on it. So hopefully some more Drop Fleet videos coming soonish. Thanks a lot.